going to tee up the conversation with just probably 5 minutes of slides. And I think everybody that's joining this LinkedIn Live or views it later can agree that data quality, poor data quality, has an impact on everybody's lives, not just in the workplace. But we're going to look at this through the lens of marketing and poor data quality and the impact on marketing and enterprise organizations in general. So three quick things. Impact of poor data quality. I'm going to try to make my point. You'll see these in stats. I think everybody will get the point about how big of an issue this is. Why is this happening? So trends in the marketplace. And then my hope is that we can impart everybody with at least a couple nuggets of wisdom on how to simply chart your course to data quality. So with that, just a couple things, and hopefully this hits home, but data quality is a massive issue across the marketing landscape. 21 cents of every dollar of media is wasted because of insufficient data quality, and this is Forrester Research. When you apply that 21 cents per every dollar to the global ad spend and media spend across the world, that equates to $120 billion of paid media spend loss every single year just because of data quality. The average company loses $14 million a year. And this is a Gartner study that was done just last year due to data quality. So this is a big issue. And then last but not least, IBM estimates that the yearly cost of poor data quality just in the US alone is over $3 trillion. And this was done in 2016. So you can imagine how much bigger this number has gotten with the advancement of companies, technologies, and the amount of data that has been produced just in the last year alone. So I think everybody gets the point. Poor data quality leads to massive business issues and massive dollar loss across an enterprise. So why is this continued to be an issue? Well, simply running a business used to be simpler. When you think about 20 years ago, you had a couple teams in a couple different areas, but now, you know, especially over the last 18 months, you have teams that are all over the world that are in fragmented offices working from home. You used to have a few systems and channels, and you had a limited pool of data. But now you look at what software has done to the marketing industry and the enterprise in general. The average enterprise has 50 or more customer experience solutions in their marketing organization, 288 SaaS applications enterprise-wide. And it's not just about the number of applications. It's the different connection points and touch points that you now have across people and teams in these applications, which is over 21,000 in the average enterprise. And then you couple that, and we alluded to this a little while ago, with just over the last 18 months, data volume and complexity has exploded. In the wake of the pandemic, most companies had to jump ahead 5 years in their data strategy in a matter of weeks to try to catch up and transform into this new world of everybody expecting things instantaneously online in a digital world. And then the world is going to create three times the data in the next 5 years. So you have more software, more technology, more digital touch points, and more data that's being created since the dawn of time. And then you exacerbate that with trying to do this either at regional or global scale. So all of these factors lead to massive issues with data quality. Now, what everybody wants is this beautiful house of data, this beautiful marketing technology or enterprise-wide technology stack. But the reality is, if you have not invested the time and the people, the process, and the software investment into trying to standardize this and unifying this and really honing in on data quality, this is what happens when you open that door. But we are convinced, and you know, we're a little bit biased here in Claravine because we work with some of the largest brands in the world and their agency partners, and we have the privilege of having these conversations every day. We are convinced that with a couple simple things and a massive focus on these things, that every single marketer and every single enterprise can get far along that path to data quality, far along that journey. The first is, so really four elements that we want people to focus on. Implement a unified data taxonomy. So much of data quality is about ensuring that every single data element that you're capturing is named correctly. As simple as that sounds, think about all the systems, the technologies that your organization has spent tens, maybe hundreds of millions of dollars on. They're only as good as the inputs going into those systems, whether it's AI, ML, some optimization platform, any type of experience or a BI tool trying to visualize the data. the first thing you must do is implement a unified data taxonomy across the enterprise. Maybe start it out in the marketing org because there are so many digital touch points there, but ensure that you get to the point and you chart this course that is not a quick one and done course, but this course to data quality by implementing this unified data taxonomy. Don't just take our word for it. There's a great article I wanted to reference. It was an Ad Exchanger back in June of this year. You should check it out. But massive organizations like Mondelez have gone on this journey, and it doesn't happen overnight. If you read this article, this is a 3-year process, but it has a significant, I cannot stress this enough, data quality and unifying your taxonomy and your data language has a monumental impact on your bottom line. In the case of Mondelez, ROI is up 70% since 2017. So the truth is out there. It's not just us saying this at Claravine. It's amazing CPG companies like Mondelez and their partners. In this case, it was actually Mighty Hive Media Monks that helped them on this journey. So unify your taxonomy. Cannot stress that enough. Stop defining data in a vacuum. You know, oftentimes this data problem, this is a space vacuum, by the way, in case you didn't see it. This is happening because data is built and data is being leveraged in silos. You need to commit to this journey and making sure that all the constituents that are touching or need the data have the say in how that data is actually going to be mapped back so they can have say in what they need to get out of this enterprise taxonomy. Second thing is unified data definitions. As simple as it might sound, when organizations start calling the same things by the same names, data elements, other factors in data, it can change the organization overnight, whether that's an ad unit, a channel, a campaign, just unify those data definitions and agree upon them across organizations so you break down those silos. And then last but not least, once you have that unified taxonomy, everybody has agreed on what that taxonomy is, how you will name things across the enterprise, you need to have a single source of truth across these systems. You need something that these teams, oftentimes globally in nature, can access the data, can transform the data, look at the data, and ensure that all of the data, when they're pushing out a marketing campaign across dozens of channels or touch points, all of that data is being captured accurately in the naming conventions that they need. So if you can do those four things, I think you're going to be on your way. But I can't stress enough, this is a journey. This is not something that is done in a matter of months or years. It's something that the enterprise and especially marketing organization needs to commit to. And they need to have rigor to it. They need to have process to it. And especially now more than ever with all the changes going on in our industry, this is a vital commitment and a vital journey that we believe that every single organization should go on.
All right. Thank you, EJ, for giving us this background on the importance of data quality and for sharing some methods on how to help manage it. So thank you for that. But now we do have time for a few questions that we have queued up here. Again, if anybody watching has any questions, please leave them in the comments, or even if you're catching this after the live has ended, we would still be happy to answer them. So the first question we have here is, how does poor data quality affect aspects of the business other than marketing?
Yeah, great question. And we've worked with a lot of companies that, and again, there's a little bit of a marketing lens to this, but the financial operations, right? They need data quality, they need data standards, a unified data taxonomy to try to map back which campaigns were you spending money that we need to bill or invoice, do you need purchase orders, simple things like that. Think about HR. Data quality is vital for HR. Data quality permeates every single organization across the enterprise. I mean, we focus on the marketing organization, but we run into things like revenue and sales ops, again, in the finance organization, having data standards in place so people can properly track and attribute revenue to pay salespeople or to attribute campaigns and success. So it's not just a marketing problem. It's a finance and HR. It's a data quality problem across the entire enterprise.
Yeah, it's definitely something that all organizations and departments in the organization should keep in mind. And with that, a question that many marketers may have, which is with the new privacy regulations for Google and Apple, what is their impact on poor data quality in the coming years?
Yep. So I cannot stress enough. I'm sure everybody that's watching this or will watch this, just the last week alone, there's been an iOS 15 update. Facebook has talked about embracing MMM. Google has pushed out new attribution modeling and metrics. all the changes with IDFA, third-party cookie deprecation coming next year. The wisdom and advice I would give to everybody is control what you can control, right? These changes are going to continue to happen. Having a unified taxonomy and data standards in place is going to help you. We are about to embark on this journey, and I know many enterprise organizations and marketers are starting to do this from a world of observation where you could observe, and there was so much data that was available to you through cookies, retargeting, all these other elements, identification mechanisms, to a world, which actually I'm excited about, which is more about experimentation. And if you don't know what the inputs are that are going into those experiments, you don't know how you're labeling audiences and cohorts, you're labeling campaigns, the data elements that you're capturing, it's going to be really challenging and people are going to have to play catch up. So again, with all of these changes, control what you can control. And the first step to having that control is just to having a unified taxonomy across your organization.
All right. It's definitely something to address sooner rather than later, it sounds like. So 100%. With that final question that many may wonder when they first start the process of cleaning up their data, which is how long does it take to typically fix poor data quality?
This I wish there was a silver bullet for this one, Casey, but this is the question everybody always asks. Like, I can't stress this enough. This is not a sprint to the finish line. This is a marathon. This is something that you need as an organization to embrace, and it has to be ingrained in your DNA. You have to first commit to data quality, and then this is a journey that you have to go on. You have to put rigor in place, process. But this is a years of journey. If you think back to the slide that I showed with that article about Mondelez, that's 3 years in the making. And I'm sure if you interviewed the folks at Mondelez, they would tell you that this is an iterative, ongoing process. We find that with all the brands that we work with and their agency partners. Those that commit to this and realize that this is not just let's set it and forget it. This is let's put process in place, have rigor around it, continue to go back and make sure that that taxonomy is correct. They will be set up for years and years of success. And this is going to be something that you have to embrace for the future. It's not something that you just do and forget about.